Breaking news first at 4. A new search has just concluded for a local woman who's been missing for 6 years. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Aixa Diaz. Jennifer Kessie vanished in 2006. All day, teams have been scouring a wooded area in South Orange County, hoping to solve a case they deemed exhausted 2 years ago.
Now, Chopper 2 was over the search area. Today's search required a massive effort to cover a massive area. West 2's Dave McDaniel has been following the search teams all day. And Dave, where exactly are you and what brought the searchers there?
Well, we are basically about 3 or 4 miles south of SeaWorld on International Drive, a part of International Drive that a lot of people aren't all that familiar with. We're very near World Center Drive. The investigators came here because they had a tip that this area might have some clues to Jennifer Kessie's disappearance, and they said when they got that tip, the area was too wet. Only now is it dry enough for them to get in and investigate. On ATVs and on horseback, a swarm of emergency responders with machetes. This 800-acre wooded area was too wet to search when the tip first came in. Orlando police tell us they're not even sure when the tip came in, but once they determined the site was one which could be searched, they sent in more than 70 people. Canines to see if they could sniff out any clues, boots on the ground to see if any evidence can solve this mystery. 24-year-old Jennifer Kessie vanished January 24th, nearly 6 years ago. Efforts to find her, other searches have come up empty. Even her car, found nearly right away, hasn't led to Jennifer or to any suspects in her possible abduction. For a time, the FBI took up this case before giving it back to OPD. Jennifer's family is here, glad to know that there's still being work done on the case, hoping to get an answer, even if the answer leads to more sadness. And unfortunately for the Kessie family, the Orlando Police Department just released that the search has concluded and that nothing of significance was found. But still, both Drew and Joyce Kessie came out and spoke with us just a few moments ago. Both of them thanked the Orlando Police Department and all of the members of law enforcement for their continued search and asked everybody in the community to keep Jennifer Kessie in their thoughts.
But we are so thankful for the community and law enforcement for continuing to try and find our daughter. She needs to come home. And one of these times, we were hoping it was today, we're going to find something that's going to lead us to Jennifer. One of these times. And we ask you, and I know we've asked you this for 6 years almost now, but we ask you to please not stop looking, thinking about Jennifer. Call in any tip to Crime Line. There still is rewards out.
I first met the Kessies the day Jennifer first disappeared, and they have been compassionate and helpful throughout. They say that each day it does not get easier. They do want answers, and again, they were very thankful that this search happened today, and they hope that more searches will happen, and they believe that OPD has kept this case on the front burner, and they're very pleased that even though nothing was found today, that the searching did occur. Reporting live in Orange County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.